Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series on food and cosmetic analysis. In this 16th video, you are going to learn about estimation of constituents of face powder, reagents required for estimation of zinc, calcium, and magnesium in face powder, and the detailed procedure for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium in face powder. So begin with this, the reagent required for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium present in the face powder are given below. First reagent is a Wulfing precipitant. It is 80 gram ammonium carbonate and 90 ml ammonium hydroxide mixed in 375 ml of water. To that 475 ml alcohol is added. The second reagent is wash solution. It is equal volume of Wulfing precipitant and alcohol are mixed. So these two reagents are used for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium from the face powder. Next is a procedure for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium present in face powder. So we will see one by one estimation of these three elements present in a face powder. So at the beginning, take approximately 2 gram face powder sample in petri dish and ignite it at 600 to 650 degree centigrade to form light gray ash. Then next, transfer this ash to Erlenmeyer flask and add 100 ml Wulfing precipitant to the above flask and shake the flask vigorously. To this solution was allowed to stand overnight, then the solution is filtered through filter paper to get filtrate and residue. So here the obtained filtrate is noted as a filtrate A, which is used for estimation of zinc, and the obtained residue is noted as a residue A, which is washed with wash solution and used for estimation of calcium and magnesium. So basically here by this procedure we are getting filtrate and residue. So filtrate is used for estimation of zinc present in a face powder and residue is used for estimation of calcium and magnesium present in a face powder. So we'll see the detailed procedure of estimation of each of these elements. So here is the procedure for formation of filtrate A and residue A shown in a pictorial format. So here is the sample solution of sample of face powder, which is ignited at 600 to 650 degree centigrade. It will form a light gray color ash. This light gray color ash is transferred into the Erlenmeyer flask containing ash and Wulfing precipitant. In this we have to add 100 ml Wulfing precipitant, then shake the flask vigorously and allow to stand for overnight. The formation of precipitate will take place. Filter through the filter paper to get filtrate A and residue A. So once you filter it, we'll get a residue which is known as a filtrate A, which is used for estimation of calcium and magnesium, and the filtrate which is obtained is known as a filtrate A, is used for estimation of zinc. So this is the whole procedure for formation of filtrate A and residue A, which will be used for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium. Then here is the detailed procedure of estimation of zinc from filtrate A. So first, to the above flask containing filtrate A, methyl red HCl and water is added and solution is boiled on hot plate. Then next, to this solution 100 ml diammonium hydrogen phosphate is added and boiling is continued for 30 minutes. Then the reaction mixture was allowed to cool at RT and then filter through previously wet crucible. Then the obtained precipitate of zinc pyrophosphate is washed with 1% diammonium hydrogen phosphate and with 50% alcohol. This residue of zinc pyrophosphate was dried and then ignited at full heat to get constant weight of zinc oxide. So weight of zinc pyrophosphate into 0.5341 is equal to weight of zinc oxide. Hence, either by weighing the zinc pyrophosphate or zinc oxide, we can calculate the weight or percentage of zinc present in the face powder. So this detailed procedure explains how much zinc or how much percentage of zinc is present in a face powder. This procedure is explained here in a form of picture. So this is the flask which contains filtrate A. So in this filtrate A, we have to add methylated HCl and water, and then we have to boil it on hot plate. So this is a boiled solution of filtrate A containing methylated HCl and water. In this solution, we have to add 60 ml diammonium hydrogen phosphate, and we have to boil it further for 30 minutes. After this, mixture was allowed to cool at room temperature and then filter through the previously wet crucible. So this is the formation of zinc pyrophosphate precipitate. This precipitate was filtered, and the precipitate of this zinc pyrophosphate is washed with 1% diammonium hydrogen phosphate and finally with 50% alcohol. And this is what the precipitate of zinc pyrophosphate, which was ignited at full heat to get zinc oxide. So by weighing the zinc oxide or by weighing the zinc pyrophosphate, we can calculate the amount of zinc present in a face powder. So this picture explains the complete procedure of estimation of zinc present in a face powder. So this is all the presentation of estimation of zinc present in a face powder. Then next is the estimation of calcium and magnesium from residue A. So the residue A obtained from wolfing precipitate is taken in petri dish and then burned at 650 degrees centigrade to form ash. To this ash, 1:9 HCl, methyl red and ammonium hydroxide is added. Further, 200 mg of ammonium sulfate and Br2 is added to destroy excess of indicator. Again, excess of bromine is removed by boiling. This solution was made alkaline by adding ammonium hydroxide and then filter through a filter paper to get filtrate and residue. The residue is discarded and filtrate B is used to determine calcium and magnesium. So this whole procedure is explained in this picture. So this is the residue A, which is obtained from the wolfing precipitant. This residue is transferred into a petri dish and it is burned at 650 degrees centigrade to form a ash. So this ash is then transferred into a flask, and in that flask, 1:9 HCl, methyl red and ammonium hydroxide is added. In this beaker, then 25 mg of ammonium sulfate and bromine is added to destroy excess of indicator. The resulting solution is then boiled to remove the excess of bromine. Then it is made alkaline by adding ammonium hydroxide. So at this stage, we'll get a precipitate. This precipitate is discarded by filtration. So it is filtered through a filter paper to get a filtrate and residue. This obtained residue is discarded, and the collected filtrate, which is known as a filtrate B, is used to determine calcium and magnesium present in a face powder sample. So this is the procedure completely describing about the estimation of calcium and magnesium. So determination of calcium from filtrate B. So to the above filtrate B, ammonium oxalate solution is added to get a calcium oxalate precipitate. This precipitate is dissolved in distilled water containing 25 ml of 14 normal H2SO4. This is heated at 70 degrees and then titrated with 0.1 normal KMnO4 solution. Hence, from the constant burette reading, we can calculate the weight or percentage of calcium present in a face powder by doing some calculations. So this is the procedure which is explaining the estimation of calcium from the filtrate. So this is the filtrate B. This filtrate B is transferring to the flask in this added ammonium oxalate solution. So here when you add the ammonium oxalate solution, the calcium present in a sample will precipitate as a calcium oxalate. So this calcium oxalate precipitate is transferred and it is filtered through the funnel. This calcium oxalate precipitate is then dissolved in a water, and in this 25 ml of 14 normal H2SO4 is added, then it is heated at 70 degree centigrade and the resulting solution is then titrated with 0.1 normal KMnO4 solution. So from the burettiding we can able to estimate the amount of calcium present in the face powder. So this whole procedure explaining the estimation of calcium present in the face powder. Next is a determination of magnesium from filtrate B. So to the above filtrate B, add 1:1 HCl, 2-3 gram of ammonium hydrogen phosphate followed by 1:1 HCl to get clear solution. This solution is made alkaline by adding ammonium hydroxide and then followed allowed to stand for 2 to 3 hours. The solution was then filtered to get residue of magnesium pyrophosphate. The residue of magnesium pyrophosphate was washed with 1:1 ammonium hydroxide till free form chloride. The precipitate of magnesium pyrophosphate is then ignited in porcelain crucible at full heat till constant weight of magnesium oxide is obtained. So here weight of magnesium pyrophosphate into 0.3622 is equal to weight of magnesium oxide. So by weighing the magnesium pyrophosphate or by weighing the magnesium oxide, we can calculate the weight or percentage of magnesium present in the face powder. See, this whole procedure is shown in this picture. So this is the filtrate which is obtained in the previous steps. So this filtrate B is transferred into the flask, and in this flask 1:1 HCl, 2-3 gram of ammonium hydrogen phosphate is added. So the clear solution in which this 1:1 HCl, 2-3 gram of ammonium hydrogen pyrophosphate is added, then add ammonium hydroxide and then allow to stand for 2 to 3 hours. So after this step, the magnesium present in the solution will form as a precipitate in the form of magnesium pyrophosphate. So this precipitate which is obtained is a magnesium pyrophosphate precipitate which is filtered and washed with 1:1 ammonium hydroxide. Then this precipitate of magnesium pyrophosphate is ignited in porcelain crucible to get magnesium oxide. So this magnesium oxide we can weigh and we can calculate the amount or percentage of magnesium present in the face powder. So this whole procedure is explaining how we can estimate the amount of magnesium present in the face powder. So dear students, the points you have learned from this video are: a reagent required for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium in face powder, and procedure for estimation of zinc, calcium and magnesium present in the face powder. So please learn next topic of this unit in my next video. Till then, I wish you a happy e-learning and thank you for watching this video.